Greetings, everybody. Yeah, I thought I'd get one more winter hop in. I was getting a little antsy. And I realized after going to Fond du Lac that as long as it wasn't bitter cold, I'm up for a winter train hop. So I wanted to redo a hop from Portage to St. Paul. The first time I didn't make it all the way to St. Paul because of issues with the train. So this time wasn't without issues as well, but I did make it eventually. And I had planned to come back via Chicago, and I blew that hop out and was escorted from the yard by a very friendly St. Paul police officer who gave me a lift to the nearest bus stop. So I do appreciate that. A quick announcement. I did write a book that kind of just is a bit memoir and train hopping combined, and a look at how you end up perhaps hopping freight trains when you're 65 plus years old. Anyway, there's a link in the description to the book, and any proceeds, if there are any, will go to help fund adventures this summer. Then while I was in, you know, speaking of 65 years plus, when I was in Minneapolis, I had the privilege of having lunch with another older train hopper named Train Doc, and wow, what a fantastic time that was. Fantastic stories from a real train hopper. Just incredible, the adventures that this guy has had. Brilliant man on top of that. So I really enjoyed my lunch with him. Anyway, on with the video. Take care.
I've been wanting to go eastbound. That would have been a pretty good ride. Especially that car right there. That greener with a pretty good lip on it. But I am headed the other direction today.
I'm going that way. What's up?
Probably have to chill a few more hours. Great ride. ride right there. Empty box car, which would have been nice on a cold night, but sometimes it doesn't work, and that thing's clear down by the station. So we're gonna take what we're given. Man, we had a traffic jam all of a sudden, that's for sure. Let's see what we got here. Sounds like that thing's airing up before I can even get to it. They might just be testing the brakes. Shitty ride.
Hey, you guys all ready to go there? Right, they just cleared up, should have something in there, or at least in there shortly. Are you, what time, if I get you guys going, what time do you think you get cleared on?
All right, I'll go ahead and send you up that way.
Good job.
Good job.
Good job.
Good
job.
Good
job.
Good
job.
Good
job.
Good
job.
Good
job.
Good
job.
Good
job.
Good
job.
Good
job.
Good
job.
Good
job.
Good
job.
Good
job.
Good
job.
Good
job.
Good
job.
Good
job.
Good
job.
Good
job.
Good
job.
Good
job.
Good
job.
Good I think maybe we had a dragging brake or something. Seems like I've ridden this route once before and had troubles on it. hopefully that's not the case this time. I guess we'll find out the sooner.
31-5, car is this level. And 281 stopped. 3 cars left.
So our engine must be 281. I suppose that could be our train number. I don't know. It's getting pretty cold though, sitting there. Not that it'll warm up once we get moving, but oh well.
The crossing gates activate again. And then they're gonna hook back up and I guess we'll be on our way. Apparently they were just dropping cars off.
281, gates are activated, warning devices. Another 25-25.
Crossing's activated,
25-27. So yeah, it was pretty close to my car. I hope we're not scheduled to get dropped off somewhere in the middle of nowhere.
All right, we got lights and gates on 281 again. Another 15 joined. Off to 12.
15 to the joint, you're off to 12. Crossing 3
activated. And a couple.
Let's see if we feel it when they connect back up.
Last one, please.
Thank you.
stop long enough outside of the pig's eye yard that I can get off here. They've got more snow than I anticipated. So I don't know if it's gonna be able to find a decent place to roll out or if I'm gonna have to break down and get the motel. But anyway, I made it.